About you, just to see what's going on with you. So how did you get into this business? What made you decide to do this?
Yeah, so I've actually been around the company for quite a while now. Family's been involved with it. I've gotten to know the three Nicks, you know, over the years. And just being around them and being around the atmosphere and everything else kind of made me get into the industry. And I figured Reno would be a great place to bring Nick the Greek to.
Awesome. And are you from Reno?
I'm actually not from Reno, from the Bay Area. But like I was talking to you earlier, I have family here. My grandparents have lived here. My dad went to school at UNR for med school. I went to school there and graduated in 17. So I'm definitely got some ties here, and I definitely enjoy the area, love the people, and love the atmosphere that Reno brings.
Yeah. So, and you'll be here locally now?
Yes, I live here now. I live right off of Keystone, so I'm close to here, and we'll be here from now on out. So
That's awesome. So why get into the food industry?
So like I mentioned, I've been around it for a while, and I kind of graduated with a marketing degree and was pursuing other paths, and just being exposed to it and, you know, being around family stores and things like that kind of made me fall in love with the whole process and, you know, the people and, you know, everything else that comes with it. It's just something that I actually found to be enjoyable. So it's something that I wanted to get into.
So here's the $1 million question. Are you Greek?
I am not actually. No, I'm one of the ones that I'm not. But like I said, there's the three Nicks. The youngest one's actually married to one of my cousins now. So we have a little bit of family ties. So it's something that, you know, even without that connection there, they made me feel welcomed and really brought me in and gave me everything I needed to succeed here. So
that's awesome. And Nick the Greek is all over.
Yes, we are actually all over California. Originated in San Jose, California back in 2014. They opened up their first store after they came up with the idea in 2012. You know, there weren't a whole lot of Greek options that the cousins were kind of, you know, experienced to in the Bay Area. So after all their trips to the Greece constantly, they came up with the idea to open up Nick the Greek. And now we are 70 plus stores over 6 states, I believe.
That's amazing. Yep. That is so cool. So what have been, this is another big question. What have been any of your, have you had any big hurdles in starting the business here?
Well, obviously me being a first time entrepreneur, you know, learning the steps of what it takes to open a business and everything else like that. But like I said, they've been there every step of the way, you know, giving me all the contacts I need and making sure that I have what I need to succeed. So just having that made the learning curve a little bit better. I didn't have to, you know, catch on. There's a lot of things that I had to take care of myself that were first time things, but other than that, it's pretty seamless. I think they did a great job, and, you know, I had to do my part obviously, but they made it, you know, well worthwhile.
Yeah. One of the benefits of being part of do we call this a franchise?
Yes, this is a franchise. Okay. Reno locations. We have about 10 corporate stores now, and then all the other locations are franchise.
Okay. Yeah. Wonderful. And you are the owner of this franchise.
Correct. Yes. I am the owner of the Reno location, and then hopefully there will be more to come after this store.
Yeah, it's very exciting.
Expand and more or less, you know, attract everybody from all over Sparks, Reno, South Reno, and everywhere else.
Well, you know, people have been talking about it, so it's definitely a thing already. Yeah. And I mean, the doors are like, people are coming in and out all day today, and it's your soft opening. So
Yeah. We have a soft opening going this week, you know, DoorDash, online, Uber Eats. You can call in and put in an order with us, and then, we'll have our grand opening on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Free lunch from 11 to 2:30. It will be packed.
It's going to be crazy.
Yeah, it's going to be a little hectic, but we're ready for it.
Expect lines. It's going to be a bit. So one of the other questions that I have for you is, how do you feel about the Reno food scene? Now that you're kind of new here, but you've been scoping it out for a while, how do you feel about it?
Well, I mean, I went to school here, and, you know, being around school and being, you know, introduced to the area and having all the options, you know, obviously there are a ton of options for food here. You know, Greek wasn't one of the things that I even looked at back in the day, and after getting exposed to this company, like, okay, I really like this food. So, you know, after doing some market research and looking around, we didn't have a whole lot of options in Reno. That kind of gave me the push to bring it here. And obviously being from here and being, you know, going to school here, that kind of gave me a little incentive. Like, okay, I think it's a great spot for it.
Yeah, I love it. Have you had any struggles getting employees?
At first, in the beginning, a little bit. I mean, it's hard for someone to come in, and we're not quite open. We're not, really, getting the training things going. But now that training's going, things are picking up. A lot of people are excited. They got to, I have people coming in like, oh, wow, this is great. Just them being in the back, them getting exposed to all of it, makes them feel a bit more comfortable. I'm like, okay, they want to be a part of this. Yeah. And I think there's a lot of opportunity here. And I've mentioned everybody here. It's a great atmosphere. It's a great place to work. I enjoy it. I quit my job out here to come start and do this. If I didn't like it, I wouldn't expect anybody else, to have that same mentality. So I'm glad they're enjoying it. They're doing great in there right now. So we'll be ready for opening. And,
woohoo, that's exciting. Yeah, you're going to have a big line. People need to be ready for lines. And then also, last question for you, unless Nate has other ones, but what is your favorite dish?
My favorite dish, I do love the chicken souvlaki. It's just something that, like I said, I've eaten this, every day for God knows how long. So it's something that I've gotten to come to love, which is right over here. You'll get to try that as well.
This is this one.
Correct. Yeah, okay. It's a chicken on the skewer. That's the plate. I usually get it in the bowl, which you have the beef lamb. And this is our actually number one seller is the beef lamb pita.
Okay.
Yeah, with our Greek fries, which is our version of garlic fries. They're really good.
Okay. Yes. I can't wait to try them. And then these. Tell me a little bit about these.
Yeah, the loops are actually a Greek, I would call it a juice, but it's a mix between a juice and like a seltzer. It's got a little bit of both. Some of them are sweet. Some people like them. Just depends on what your preference is, obviously, because there's three different options, but those are great. We also have, mineral water from Greece, a couple other options as well.
Okay, great. And is there anyone that you want to give a shout out to that's helped your business here in town?
Oh, I could shout out the three Nicks. They're obviously, like I said, it's great. They brought me in, treated me like family. My builder, Bill Ross, and Bob. And anybody else that's, just the community of Reno, the health department, city, fire, you name it, they've all been a great help with getting things up and going.
Good. Anything else you want us to know?
Nope, that is it. Other than the opening on the 29th, and be ready with the appetite.
Yeah, that's going to be crazy. Well, thank you, Richard. This was great.
Of course, thanks for stopping by.
I can't wait to dive in.